Hi, this is Tammy Karachik for July the 8th, 2019. I went to the Park Theater on Saturday to see Schools Out and to also meet Pat Mastroianni, who played Joey Jeremiah, and Stacey Mystician, who played Caitlin Ryan. And it was, to say the least, I was a little bit starstruck. And I never, ever get starstruck because people who are in the movies or athletes, etc., they're just people like the rest of us, right? Pat and Stacey are just so relatable. And I think that's what just made it even more, I think, awesome, because they didn't even use mics to talk to us. They just kind of really, you just felt like they were a friend. And it just felt that much more comfortable when you could do that. When some people were just kind of, you know, hand on the back of their chair, kind of like, so did you get any fan mail? You know, stuff like that. And you're so casual, you know. They didn't, you know, stand up all nervous, you know, with a mic going, in episode 53, you know what I mean? There wasn't any of that. It was just, it was so cool and casual. We could relate to these characters so much. And I related to Caitlin and Joey, because I mean, like, their love story was just so romantic and everything else, and then they would break up and they would get back together. And if any of you know my history, that is kind of what happened to me when I was in high school. Your friends. And one of the reasons Pat said that he wanted to bring Degrassi out, because as he said that back in when the show ran, is that he obviously, there wasn't Instagram, Facebook, you know, so he could, you know, thank the fans. And he said now he has the opportunity to go out there. He didn't know they had such a following and that they were still popular. And when he found that out, he wanted, you know, to get out there. But it was actually not humorous. He'd been approaching Comic-Con for 5 years in Winnipeg, and they would always say no. And then there was a guy by the name of Mike who was at the park. And so he told him, you know, what a huge fan base you do have in Winnipeg. And he said, why don't you come to the Park Theater? We'll do a screening. And so, long story short, that's what happened. Thank you, Mike. And so that's exactly what happened. And so let's get to the screening. Before that, I'm going to mention that Stacey also received a lot of fan mail from jails. I still can't believe that. So the screening, if anybody expected to watch the screening with just some popcorn and some pop and just go, well, that was a lovely movie. No, it was a great movie. I mean, I watch it every single year whenever I would cover grad. So Joey and Caitlin pull up in his totally cool car, and Joey gets out of the car and he's like, I can't believe it's almost midnight. And everybody just started laughing because it's like, Joey's young. It's like, why are you worried about midnight? And then the other one was when Tessa and her boyfriend Todd had a fight, and so she leaves the party, and so she's sitting outside, and Joey walks out because he just proposed to Caitlin and she, you know, refused him. And so she said, you know, I'll put the ring on my right hand. And then Tessa says to Joey when, you know, they're outside, you know, are you going home? And he said, yes, why? Can I get a lift? And we live in the same area, but somebody in the crowd goes, oh, he can give you a ride. So kind of deal. So that kind of set the tone for the rest of the show. It was a lot of, I wouldn't call it heckling, but it was a lot of like hooting and hollering and stuff like that. It was just, it was hilarious. One of the other things was whenever Tessa would come on screen, there would be some derogatory comments that would be, you know, thrown out. And then, you know, when Caitlin would come out, you know, it would be like, you know, poor Caitlin and stuff like that. But a couple of the things that really stood out was when Snake jumped into the water to save Allison, everybody was yelling at first, go Snake, go Snake. And then when he actually did go into the water, everybody was yelling, Snake, Snake, Snake. And I really hope that gets back to Stefan Bjorg, who plays Snake, because that was just one of like the most awesome moments. One thing that Pat did say was that there was a question posed to him about the Zit Remedy. That was the band that was in the show. It wasn't in Schools Out, but it was in the Degrassi Junior High episodes and the High episodes. Whether he and Snake and Wheels, which was comprised of Pat Mastroianni and Neil Hope and Stefan Bjork, were they as close as they were in the movie, or sorry, in the episodes as they were in real life? And he said yes. And then because Neil Hope died in 2000, and well, we didn't find out about it in 2000 until 2012, but he had died actually about 4 years, 5 years earlier. However, he said what makes him happy is to know that he will live forever in those movies, in Schools Out and in Degrassi High and Degrassi Junior High and in Kids at Degrassi Street. And that was kind of for me, it was really touching because I still remember the day when I found out, and I was in one of the newsrooms that I work at, or in sorry in Edmonton where that I worked at, and it just kind of nobody knew who Neil was. Nobody had watched Degrassi, and it just kind of you kind of feel. I went home and I really did feel alone. you really do feel like you did lose a friend. And I watched a 30th anniversary special that Stefan Bjork had hosted, and I cried because you just feel that you did lose somebody, and it does hit you, that this wonderful Canadian actor is gone. But one of the other things that did happen in this movie, when Joey and Caitlin finally do see each other at the end, they and it's at Alexa and Simon's wedding. She asks him, do you want to dance as old friends? And then he says, I'd like that. And everybody started applauding. It was a fantastic night. And the Degrassi Palooza that happened in Toronto, there was a lot of footage that was captured from there. And so Pat Mastroianni did say that what he would love to do is to make that into a documentary and bring that back to Winnipeg in about 2 years. So hopefully that is done in about 2 years or so, and I cannot wait until that. And I was in the second row for the screening and the Q&A, and if that happens, I'm sitting in the front row. So that I am so excited and so grateful that this happened, because so many people were saying this was a once in a lifetime opportunity. This was the best night of their life, and it really was amazing. So, but I just want to just thank like Pat and Stacy, and also to Mike and Marlene, who were responsible for bringing Pat and Stacy to the city, and also to Corey, who was the souvenir guy. So, but it was just an amazing night. It the little 12-year-old girl inside of me just screamed when I found out that they were coming. So, but thanks for listening for almost 13 minutes. Cameo.